92.5.
Brooke and Jubal in the mornings. Second date update.
Ava is on the phone to do a second date update today, and her email said that she went out on the best date of her life.
Ooh.
Which, depending on her life, could either be really cool or really sad. I don't know. I have to learn more about her life first.
Good point.
Before I decide if that's a good thing. Ava, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Not too bad. Thank you for asking. So you had the best date of your life, huh?
I did. Yeah. It was, like, amazing. I'd never been out with a guy like this ever.
Okay.
Okay. Have you been on a lot of dates to compare it to?
Yeah, so I've been doing the whole dating app. I'm like in that world, and they're all just really immature and always on their phone.
The dude that you want to call today, what's his name?
His name is Nathan.
Nathan. All right, and what sets Nathan apart from the other dudes that you've been out with?
Well, he is just really mature and has a full-time job, and
That's all.
That. Yeah, I love
best
that.
Date of my life. The guy was like kind of mature and worked full time.
He was normal.
Sweet.
Yeah. I mean, that's where we've come, right? He's employed. Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And like I was just attracted to him right when I saw his profile picture. I love dogs, and so it was he and his dog.
Oh,
and
always a good one to put for a guy. They know that we fall for that.
Yes. We started messaging and we agreed to hang out.
So your expectations for this hangout were already really high going in.
There was just something about the messages that I just felt like, okay, this guy has his life together.
He was like, he has punctuation and it's so sexy.
Yeah.
Slightly professional.
Yeah. He could spell your right,
yeah.
Which is cool. So how was the actual date with him though?
It was great. So he, you know, he took the lead. He suggested a restaurant for us to go to. And it was really cool. It was, you could see like the planes, like these small planes landing where we could eat. And it was just really just different.
Nice.
And romantic. You know, we didn't like go to a pub or anything.
Right.
And then halfway through the meal, he told me he's actually a pilot.
Oh, my God.
Oh.
You took your panties off right there and threw them at him, didn't you?
He's got a good job.
And he definitely doesn't sound like a douche because a douche would lead with that right away.
Yes,
you know?
Exactly.
Yeah, I'm real busy. I'm a pilot. You know what that is? It's where I fly planes.
That's true, though.
Yeah, and I even asked him because I didn't see it in his profile or anything, and he said he just likes to kind of keep it on the down low.
That is
right.
Cool. Good
you,
move.
You don't want to be dated just so that someone can go on a free vacation.
Right, right. And, you know, a guy in a uniform, you know.
Yeah.
It depends what kind of uniform.
Like
fast food uniform, probably not getting you turned on as a pilot uniform. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I don't think the fast food one would work out as well.
Yeah, it's not quite the same.
Get like a lot of calls about strange dates, and so like this wasn't a strange date at all because okay, so we were having a great time, and then he asked me if I would like to experience flying a plane.
What?
Whoa.
He's gonna take you up in his plane right then?
Yeah, so we flew over the city. It was so romantic.
Dude.
And it was around sunset time.
Perfect.
What are you on, the Bachelorette or something? That's amazing.
That's what I felt like.
Wow.
You stayed the night at his house or something then, right?
Brooke assumes.
Well, I'm just saying, like, that is a lot of romance,
like,
not to, like, make it happen.
Oh, no, not on the first date.
Okay.
Oh.
Wow.
All right. So after he took you up in his plane, was that the end of the date, or did you guys, I don't know, do something else, visit his castle or something?
Well, the highlight was he asked if I wanted to, like, take control of the plane. And so I did. I mean, not for that long, but I did. It was,
yeah.
It was so exciting.
I mean, this all sounds perfect, and this guy is not calling you back.
No. And, he was really respectful. We ended the date with a hug.
Huh.
And then we texted the day after, and he said he wanted to see me again.
He did.
We made plans. Yeah, he did.
Okay.
So the day before, he rescheduled, so we pushed it back.
Mm-hmm.
And then he rescheduled again.
Okay.
And then it was like crickets. I didn't hear anything from him. And,
that sucks.
So how long has it been since he responded to you?
It's been about a week and a half.
Oh, wow. All right. Yeah, he's definitely blowing you off for some reason. You can't think of anything?
No. I mean, I think, you know, we're both dating, so maybe there's someone else.
Or maybe, you know, he rescheduled twice. Like, maybe the momentum of the date just, like, fizzled out. You know, sometimes that happens where you get so much space between you and that great time you had that you kind of almost forget.
It's like too much separation.
Right.
I don't know. I would love to see him again, but I don't know why he's not. I mean, he's not even responding to my text messages.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, we'll play a song, and then we'll come back and call him and get your second date update, okay?
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Hang on.
Moving 92.5. Brooke and Jubal in the Morning's second date update.
If you're just joining us for today's second date update, Ava is on the phone and she went out with a guy named Nathan. They had the best date of her life, she says. She went out with him, found out he was a pilot, and then after they went out to eat, he actually took her up in a plane, let her fly it for a little while, and then they landed, said goodbye, texted for a little bit, and then he just dropped off the face of the earth and she hasn't heard from him. Ooh. Ava?
Wow. Yeah.
I'm thinking that like a mild-mannered dude like that that you don't realize has a cool job until he tells you halfway through the date and then just disappears. I think maybe the problem is he's Batman.
Oh, God, why didn't we figure that out earlier?
Bruce Wayne.
Yeah, he's probably busy fighting crime right now. And he'll get back to you as soon as he captures the Penguin or whoever he's capturing right now. No?
No, I'm not attracted to Batman, so...
Oh. Okay. All right. Well, we'll find out. I'm about to call him. Anything else you want to say before we do?
I just want to know what happened.
Yeah. Yeah. Hopefully it's just a scheduling thing. Maybe it's going to be really simple.
Sounds like
a
busy guy.
Yeah. He's a pilot. Maybe he's out flying around. Mm-hmm. Probably not in a Batmobile, but, you know, or whatever Batman flies.
Got a plane or something.
Bat plane.
Bat copter.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to dial this one right now. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Here we go.
Hello?
Hi, may I speak to Nathan, please?
Yes, this is he.
Nathan, what's up, man? How are you? This is Jubal from Brooke and Jubal in the Morning. It's a radio show.
Why are you calling me today?
Just checking in. See how you're doing?
Checking in.
Yeah.
I don't know any of you guys.
I know you
Hi,
don't.
Nathan.
Nathan, I'm calling you today because we do a segment on our show called The Second Date Update. Have you ever heard of anything like that?
I know of things like that. Oh, this is awkward. I mean, do you need me to say something or do? I mean, I don't understand. Why did you guys call me?
I'll explain. So a second date update is where if you go out on a date with somebody and then end up not talking to them after, they can email us to get you on the phone and find out what happened. So we got an email about you from a girl named Ava.
Okay.
She told us all about your date. And said it was honestly one of the best dates of her life, if not the best date of her life.
Not to put
And then you guys were scheduling another date, and you rescheduled twice, and then you just haven't talked to her for like a week and a half. So she's wondering if something went wrong.
Look, I'm glad that she had a good time. I feel bad, but something happened in my life, and I kind of had to focus on that for a while. I haven't really been heavy into the dating scene or anything. And
are you okay?
Oh, I'm fine. Yeah. Physically, health wise, everything. I had kind of a life changing occurrence happen in my life. So I had to focus on that.
So is it one of those things where we could tell her, don't worry, he'll hit you back after time passes and he's figured some stuff out?
Maybe that's a possibility. Here's the thing. I just recently got my first job with like a big commercial airline.
Oh, congrats. Hey, that's a big deal.
Awesome for you, man.
Yeah, it's just probably a lot of stress and stuff.
Yeah.
Thank you. I mean, it is a lot of stress, but it's also, you know, there's other things that come along with it, and I put all my eggs in that basket.
Oh, so it's your schedule.
What other things come along with it?
Can you guys please promise me that you're not going to tell her this?
Sure. Yeah.
We won't. You
tell us what it is and we won't tell her.
Look, to be perfectly honest, it's the stewardesses. Oh, my God.
What?
You guys know the rumors. There's so many. There's young stewardesses that come in. They're all just ready to go. There's so many of them, and they look at you like you're a rock star when you're on a commercial airline.
Oh.
Okay, so it's not the busy schedule or you just want to focus on work right now. You want to focus on as many stewardesses as possible.
I mean, I got to tell you, there's no other profession that's got this much tail.
You guys, it's flight attendants. We're not in 1950 anymore. So can we just...
Okay, flight attendant, executive assistant, stewardess, airline attendant, whatever you want to call them, they're ready and able and willing to go.
Oh, my God.
Wow. Wait. So are you, I guess.
Hey.
Have you already hooked up with a flight attendant or two?
I mean, one or two in my life, but nothing like this point. Like, I have a friend that's at an airline, let's just call it Smelta Airlines. He just, every weekend, he's just a new stewardess every weekend.
I never thought of that.
It's unbelievable.
Wow. And they get hotel rooms and everything after
you guys, do you guys stay at the same hotel and stuff? So
it's like an Olympic Village situation.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
I'm never going to be able to board a flight again without wondering who hooked up with who that is part of the staff.
I never thought of that.
It's an exciting lifestyle where we're going from city to city all across the world, and everyone's acting like it's vacation all the time. And I just figure, look, of course I want to settle down at some point, but it's just too much of an opportunity. Not.
Okay. Well,
You gotta sow your wild pilot oats before you settle down.
Exactly. You have to take advantage of being the movie star while you have the opportunity.
Absolutely.
I guess congrats. I mean, you're being honest.
There's these parties that I've heard about. They call them bang bang parties.
What?
I've been waiting for years to be involved in this inner circle.
Wow.
Are you being
for congratulations on making it to the bang bang party circuit.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah, no problem. Hey, Nathan, I do have to let you know something, though.
What?
I told you earlier that we wouldn't tell Ava, and I guess I kind of meant that because you sort of did, because she's actually on the other line listening and wants to talk to you. Maybe.
Wait, what?
Yep. Ava, are you still on the phone?
Yeah. I'm on the phone.
Ava is here and wants to talk to you.
I'm like speechless. Wow.
I bet.
I am too.
Yeah, bang bang parties.
Ava, oh my God, I had no idea you were listening. I'm so sorry that you had to hear all that. Why'd you guys do that?
I don't know, it slipped my mind.
Sure.
Dawned on me right now.
Oh my God, Nathan, is that seriously how you feel? You just want to like be promiscuous all over the world?
Well, come on, it's not all that I want to do. That's not who I am. Okay, it's an opportunity. You got to jump on it. It's like going skydiving or going to Australia. You have to be able to live life to the fullest. Come on, if you were in my position, you would jump on that.
No, I would not, okay? What you do is who you are. And when you hung out with me, you said you wanted kids. You know, you wanted to settle down. I mean, who was that person?
That's still you're this just... person. That's just this person in maybe 5 or 10 years from now.
Okay, well, you left that out. You should have, like, put that in.
Well, I'm putting it in now.
Wow. I mean, you seemed like such a sweet, nice gentleman the night that we went out. And you're actually just one of those players who just wants to, like, get it on with every flight attendant. Or you call them stewardesses. They're not... stewardesses or flight attendants.
Ava, I'm not a player, okay? A player is someone that dates multiple people at the same time. I don't do that. I have respect for women in that regard, okay? I'm single when this is happening.
You just went on about an Olympic Village? What are you talking about?
Everyone's single when that's happening.
I gotta say, Ava, he has a point. I mean, like, he didn't know that this was going to happen, and now he just wants to be totally single and hook up with other totally single people.
Right, but I just don't understand why you just couldn't tell me that after we went out on a date. Mm-hmm. I don't know why you couldn't have just said you don't want to get into anything serious. Why did you have to, like, disappear?
Look, I just got my first job with, like, a big commercial airline. And I wanted to focus on that.
Honestly, I'm just so disgusted. I mean, you seemed like a really nice person, and I guess I was just totally, I was wrong.
I understand you're upset, but I mean, I'm about to go on this venture and then be flying a lot. I'd be happy to put you into the rotation.
What? Oh my God.
Wow.
That is bold, sir.
You just proved my point, okay?
Oh, wow. Kinda,
with that being said, Nathan, would you like to go on a second date with Ava? We'll pay for it.
Good timing.
Yeah, I think that was the perfect time to ask.
Yeah, I don't want to be part of your, like, bang, bang rotation parties, okay? The Mile High Club, whatever you people call it.
Well, it's your loss.
I don't think I'm going to be able to go.
Your loss.
You're
All right. Well, sorry, Ava, it didn't work out for you.
Oh, man.
No bang bang parties in your future, I guess.
That's totally fine with me. I'm glad I know.
Nathan, thank you for being honest with us. Continued success in your new job.
Yeah, keep flying those friendly skies, bro.
I mean, I guess you're doing it for the passion of flying, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Sounds like it. Brooke and Jubal in the morning. A text in at 78592 says, I'm a pilot and I haven't heard of any bang bang parties. Maybe I'm flying with the wrong carrier.
Yeah.
This is Brooke and Jubal in the morning talking about today's second date update. If you missed it, Ava went out with an amateur pilot who took her on a private flight and even let her take control of his plane for 30 seconds. And she said it was the best date of her life. Well, when we got the dude on the phone, his name is Nathan, we found out that he just got hired by a big commercial airline. And now he's living it up and having bang bang parties with hot single airline flight attendants.
He's a rock star in the
sky. So he said when they first met, he was just like a normal dude who was trying to get a job with a big airline. And he finally got it after they went out. And now he's just living the life of a captain having bang bang parties.
Oh,
okay.
Man.
Which, by the way, he hasn't actually been to a bang bang party yet, from what I understand.
Right.
He just thinks they're going to happen for him.
Yeah.
I think he's going to be disappointed.
She was extremely disappointed that Nathan was acting completely different on their date than he actually is in real life. Mm-hmm. And he felt bad, but said he wants to take advantage of his opportunity and be wild and single.
Enjoy
while he can.
Buddy.
So he did mention that he would put Ava in his rotation if she was interested, though.
Wow. Rotation. I mean, you know what? That is romantic.
Mm-hmm. She said she wasn't interested in that, though, so no second date. Remember, if you want to do a second date update, all you have to do is email the show, and we will call the person who didn't call you back. Young Jeffrey's Song of the Week is coming up at 8:10.